going. So we've decided we really want to educate you a little bit tonight.
Let's get a little culture.
Because this will bring in all the bucks, is what we're told. So we decided to bring in two of the foremost professors
of 20th century music.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's bring in Professors Rose
and Sullivan. Before you guys get going, do you guys need anything?
Oh, no, we have something backstage.
Great.
Thank you so much.
Hi, guys. I'm Professor Sullivan of the Berklee School of Music.
I'm Professor Rose of the Juilliard School of Music.
And we travel around to various schools and places of culture to discuss what is our preeminent knowledge, which is 20th century music.
The 20th century had a number of innovations, which is something we're very passionate about. Sometimes we don't see eye to eye on every little thing, but, you know, we're really passionate about it, so we have the same common goal.
Absolutely. So, why don't I just begin by...
Oh, please.
We'll talk about, Mr. Haynes, if you please,
we have to display.
The band that I feel has defined 20th century music. Now, pre-20th century, you could simplify definition of music with three words, and that, of course, would be Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart, conductor or something. But back in the 20th century, all you needed was a simple measurement of weather. So that would, of course, be 98 degrees. Now, in 1996 in Cincinnati, when Nick Lachey, Jeff Timmons, Justin Jeffrey, and Drew Lachey met, under the tutelage of Montel Jordan producer Paris DeJean, they formed a bond that could not be broken, which spawned 10 million albums sold, and such unforgettable songs as I'm Your Everything, I Do Cherish You, and the Latin-tinged, boundary-breaking Give Me Just One Night, Una Noche. And this is a band that we look on as fondly as the American flag.
You're finished?
With this section, yes.
With this section, yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to apologize my colleague, Professor Sullivan. He sometimes lets his passions get in the way of his critical thinking. I'm not sure what this is here, but I assure you it won't happen again. We're going to have a serious discussion about 20th century music now. So, let's talk about Soul of the City. Soul of the City is these three young Canadian men in 1999, Mr. Trevor Guthrie, side vocalist David Bowman, and of course the ever-talented Kevin Lucco. We're signed by Interscope Canada and released one of the definitive 20th century long players, No One Does It Better. Featuring their first greatest piece of music, Ooh, It's Kinda Crazy, which I believe was number one on the Total Request Live video charts for, I believe, full month.
3 weeks.
3.5 weeks. And of course, their classic, soulful, funky hit single, Faded, featuring one of the greatest collaborations in the 20th century with the Canadian hip-hop sensation Thrust, of course.
So, now see, you bring up that word a lot, Professor, and you bring up the word Canadian. When we're talking about the definitive Orlando sound that these bands from Canada and the Britons have just pilfered. So when you take a band and you discuss an S Club 7, or perhaps a... They look very thin like that, or perhaps a BB Mac, or the incomprehensibly named Five. And they are just constantly taking that sound that Lou Pearlman cratered and cradled in his arms and made his own.
You can't, well listen, Lou Pearlman is one of the greatest artists of the last century, okay? You can't just, listen, you take one of the greatest American groups, take one of their greatest records, of course, Down for the Get Down by Youngstown. You take that, and you place it back to back. BB Mac sooner or later, you put those two together, there's a marked difference.
You know, why don't I get in my sob? Why don't I get in my sob and drive right out of Youngstown and go over to O-Town so I can get my little dreams fulfilled?
Well, you think they're all, I think they're nothing at all.
Okay, you know what? No. Because we know about your secret shames, the bands that you seem to herald above all others. Maybe I will. The light funky ones.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah, you're talking the abomination.
No, not now.
The lyrics of Richard Cronin, which one quick buzz and I buzz like a hornet.
Not
Billy
not.
Shakespeare wrote a whole bunch of songs. That is pop culture. That is not art.
You're not doing this to me, Jack. No.
No. We're going to discuss the. No. What did we discuss?
No. We're not going to talk about this. We're not going to talk about their 1999 classic self-titled record. We're not going to talk about their classic cover of Yvonne Elman's Can't Have You. We're not going to talk about their 2001 opus, Life is Good, featuring the classic hit single Every Other Time,
Richard Truman is dead!
Would you stand on the stage?
Richard Truman is
dead!
Would
you stand on the stage?
And they reunited him!
He's dead!
On the machine! How could you do this to me?
You know what, Tyler? If you are going to shit all over my music, and if you're going to get down on me, then I will get down on you!
What was that you just said?
I said if you come in here and discuss that injury...
No! That's not what you said. Repeat to me, word for word, what you said.
I said if you get down on me, I will get down on you.
I will do anything that you want me to.
It's a game of give and take to make it through.
If you get down on me, I'll get down on you tonight. B44?
Yeah,
B44. It's never gotten better.
And it never will.
Get down. Yeah, we're good, guys. Thank you very much.